I got an email from one of our GretaWire bloggers, Peter G. You may know him. He's the one who does those sassy icons sometimes teasing me, and I post them on GretaWire. But anyway, Peter had a bunch of questions, so I thought, you know what? Great opportunity for me to answer Peter G's questions. So, here's the first one. He wants to know, what do I think of my new time slot? Can I tell you? It is to die for. Look, the other one's great. Don't get me wrong. Do not get me wrong. I was a great opportunity to be at 10 o'clock. I was grateful to have the job, but for 11 and a half years, I got home at midnight because I always did it live. And frankly, while I loved every second of it, I had no idea that 7 was so much better. And most of all, I always tell people that the great thing about it is that for 11 and a half years, 5 nights a week, I ate out of cardboard boxes, Chinese food, pizza boxes, no silverware other than plastic, paper plates. And of course, my favorite, as many of you know, was the vending machines in the break room, because I do have quite a taste for dots, you know, that those candies. So anyway, but this is great. I actually get home about 8:30. My husband and I sit around, we talk, we may watch a movie, have a glass of wine, or we go out to dinner with people, or, you know, all the things that for 11 and a half years I didn't do. So while I love 10 p.m., it was great. 11 and a half years was really enough for me, and the 7 couldn't be better, could not be better. And for those of you who missed the 10 o'clock, you have a solution. DVR us at 7, use that serious recording business, and then you can just watch us at 10. Don't tell Sean I said that. Sean will kill me, but anyway, Sean is a great show, so I don't blame you for wanting to watch Sean at 10. But anyway, all right, that's the first question. My new desk. Well, I love that too. I bought a new desk, paid for it out of my own pocket. I didn't ask Fox to pay for it, of course, because it's quite extravagant. But it's a standing desk. It goes up and down. And I got it in February, and I also bought a chair because you can bring it down to seated level. And so I bought the desk chair with it, which I think, I don't know, that probably cost $400 or $500. Well, that was a waste of money, because since I got the stand-up desk, I have yet to sit in that chair. I much prefer standing up. I feel better at the end of the day. I don't feel all squished from sitting down. I have much more energy at the end of the day. The stand-up desk, if you're considering it, I recommend it. It is absolutely fantastic. So stand-up desk, that's an A. The new studio, love the new studio. You know, before, I used to share a studio with Brett Baer and Chris Wallace. He has a Sunday show, and I think Howie Kurtz, too, has a show. But the problem is that each show, because we did so many shows in one studio, we had to keep turning the sets around and putting new sets in so that we gave the appearance that was different. And as a consequence, is that if there was something I wanted to tape in the middle of the day in the studio, it was a huge nightmare. It was a scheduling nightmare, because we had to make sure nobody else was taping anything, and we had to like move sets around in case someone had taped something before, and the set for Brett had been up, or the set for Chris. And so it was always a scheduling nightmare. It was just absolutely terrible. But this new studio, and I have no idea how I finagled this. I mean, this is like, this is just the luckiest thing in TV. We have our own studio. On the record, it's our own studio. We don't let anybody else use it. On occasion, you know, I'll let Shannon Bream use it, my friends use it. But most part is it's off limits to everybody. And it's absolutely the best thing that can happen in TV. I had no idea that having my own studio. The other thing, too, is that we're in an office building here in D.C. We're in New York, they have really grand studios, like real studios where they have 30-foot ceilings. We're in an office building on Capitol Hill so that we have proximity of Capitol Hill. That's sort of the trade-off. We can't have the big studios. But as a consequence, we have 8-foot ceilings, and when you put lighting in 8-foot ceilings, you don't look as good as you do when you have the 30-foot ceilings. And then if you have so many shows, like you have Special Report, on the record, Chris Wallace's show, Howie Kurtz's show, anybody else here, is that the lighting grid is filled with lights, and people constantly bump lights, and people get out of lighting. You know, so you know, having to share a lighting grid was also a nightmare. How am I doing in general? I don't know. You tell me. That question I'll leave for you guys. And of course, how is John doing? Thank you for asking that. John's doing great. He's passed his PET scans. I will tell you, though, that was the worst year of my life. Everybody goes through illnesses. You know, nobody escapes that one. You know, we all have family illnesses. And sort of the bright side of it is that it reminds me of what everybody goes through. And that's never a bad thing for someone in my line of work, is to know, you know, what the day-to-day challenges. But it was tough. I used to leave here at night, at 11 o'clock at night, and John got much of his treatment over in Baltimore, so I'd drive and get to Baltimore about 12:15 at night and walk into a dark hospital. I'd sleep in a chair next to his bed all night, because you have to stay in the hospital these days with a family member, because hospitals can be sort of rugged places, just to guarantee care and to make sure things are done right. And then I'd get up early in the morning, drive home, take a shower, come to work, and keep reversing it. And then when he got out of the hospital, I'd come home, and if any of you had cancer treatment, it is tough. It's awful. And John would be up all night in horrible pain, and we'd try to deal with it. So it was the worst year of my life. However, on the bright side is, and especially in times when we're discussing healthcare and what are good solutions for our healthcare, it was a good experience for someone in my line of work to go through, although it was unpleasant, because it gives us the perspective that's so important. Being there, going through it, is so much different than reading about it. So anyway, so thank you for asking, John. It's great. Here's the next one. You do a lot for others, but I'm not sure how often people ask you about you. You know what? I'm lucky. You know, and doing things for others, that, you know, I'm lucky too. Not everybody has the opportunity to do it. You know, people are so, you know, so many issues in their own lives, or have lots of children, or have financial issues or whatever. They just don't have the opportunity. But you can help people a lot of ways. Opening the door for someone trying to get through the door with a bunch of grocery bags. You know, just doing that is fun. I think there's nothing more fun than helping anybody. And I certainly am not a braggart about all the opportunities I have. I'm just lucky I can participate in these things, and I take advantage of them. But it is a huge high to be able to help people, and you can do it in very big ways, and you can do it, you know, what seems like really small ways can be big things. I mean, even opening the door for someone may change someone's day. You have no idea how doing even little things can be really fun. So, you know, I'm lucky, and that's what you can do. So anyway, there you go. Peter G., I answered all your questions, and hope you all watch On the Record at 7 p.m., and stay here on GretaWire.